I've been away for quite some time and a lot of things have changed. Lots of insane games are coming out, both Fallout New Vegas and Skyrim modding community are popping up, and even a dog revealed that he's not a dog.
These are thrilling times.
I wanted to recreate what I've done for Skyrim Anniversary Edition, but the focus this time is going to be the greatest game ever made, Fallout New Vegas.
Fuck off then.
This is an introduction type of video. I've made many Fallout New Vegas modding videos and the problem is always me. My format is messy, the way I do those videos is unclear. Many people or many of you guys who are watching are always leaving visually being confused. I will up the quality, try to make things as clear as possible, and I'm gonna roll episodes for this, so it's very important to watch every part of it and move from episode 1 to episode 2 and from episode 2 to episode 3. Let me answer to some of your questions. Why even bother watch this video? Like, what are you gonna gain from this? What's the point? Well, on YouTube, as far as I'm aware, there is nobody who is going to make series how to mod Fallout New Vegas step by step. We are going technical here. I will show you how to make a load order working. I will show you how to have 700 plugins. And you might consider how can you make your game run, because I know how to cook. I can show you how to mod your game without having any crashes and any other issues that you are going to encounter watching any other videos right now. I will speak today about the mod manager that we are using, that is called Mod Organizer version 2.5. You can download this by googling it on the internet. They have a Discord, so install it and get this whole. I will talk about this later. Second reason why you should watch this video is because I understand completely how to make Fallout New Vegas be fully remastered, fix all of the issues, add a bunch of more things without having the game lose its original spirit. I've done the same for Anniversary Edition, and if you are interested in watching that, you can go to my channel, check for playlist, and find my latest Anniversary Edition videos. I am going to do the exact same for Fallout New Vegas. Third reason why you should watch this video is because I'm going to show you how to properly assemble mods and get your game running. If you understand the basics of what we are doing here, and let's be honest guys, this is not Breaking Bad, we're not running a meth lab or something here, this is literally us installing mods. I mean, I'm gonna get off the horse here really quick, break the fourth wall or whatever. Once you understand how this works, you can mod your game anytime you want with the things I am going to show you, what mods you should use, what mods you should avoid. We're gonna speak about load orders and a bunch of things, and again, this is an introduction. So here is how we're going to do this. If you look here, we have the Viva New Vegas. We're going to use Viva New Vegas. Don't go and do this on your own, because I'm gonna do that on the next episode. I want this to be an introduction. I am going to use the basis of Viva New Vegas, and the reason why I'm doing this again is because every 4 or 6 months or so, Viva New Vegas gets updated, because many of the core mods gets updated, like Johnny Guitar or even the script extender, and the list goes on. If you guys want to like this video, and I see enough people are interested into this, on the next episode we are going to completely install everything with Viva New Vegas together, and on every episode aside from this one of course, or the Viva New Vegas one, I will always make a document where I will show you my load order, so you will have no issues with that. Now, first of all, let's start from the basics, right? On Fallout New Vegas, guys, we are using every single DLC. I'm sorry, but instead of buying 2 kebabs or 3 coffees, you can just use this money to buy the best game ever made. Some of you are asking me, oh Kavou, what if I don't have the DLCs? Just get them. We're spending about 5 or 10 bucks for hundreds of hours of playtime, so we are using all of the DLCs. Second thing, Mod Organizer 2.5. Go ahead and install this crap. Now, It is not going to look like this, so don't get intimidated. Once you install Mod Organizer 2.5, you need to go to configurate settings and workarounds and whatever the crap is called, and you want to click the associate with download with manager links to skip through the verification process, and it will bring the mod you are downloading on your download section here. I know what you're thinking. Kavou, my friend, why use Mod Organizer 2.5 and not use Vortex or, I don't know, something else, my microwave? It's very simple. Vortex works amazingly with modernized games like Skyrim or Elden Ring, but when it comes to super old games, the problem with Vortex is that it cannot handle conflicts that well. That means if you're going to run from around 50, 200 or, in our case, 700 plugins, Vortex is going to completely destroy your game. I don't want to sound too dramatic, but you cannot mod Fallout New Vegas while using Vortex. You can't. Nobody ever did it. And you won't be the first, because I've tried. We need to use Mod Organizer 2.5. I use Vortex for Skyrim, I use Vortex for Mounted Blade, alright? I'm not gonna tell you that you should always use Mod Organizer, but specifically for Fallout New Vegas, unless something changes, this is what we need to use. And it's very simple, because let me show you, for example, right? Let's say, and again, don't install this. I want you to see this so you can understand what I'm talking about. I am randomly going to pick this. We always go down. If you guys have watched my anniversary edition videos, you always need to read. So for instance, we don't have any requirements for this, which means it's great. I always like to read the compatibility. For instance, we are not doing Tales from the Two Wastelands, so this mod is going to add a bunch of sounds. And what we do, we go to the files, you click Mod Manager, and you click Slow Download. Once you go to your download section, you will see this is the mod we install. So how things work with Mod Organizer 2.5 is that you have the download page here with all of the things you are downloading. So for instance, once we download this, you can click it, you can change the name, which we will talk about this on the next episode. Click OK, and here is the mod installed. If I go and click on this, the folder or the ESM will be activated. Now, you see this section called the plugin section. If you go to the plugin section, our mod should appear on the last here, on the end. But why it doesn't appear? That's a good question. It doesn't appear because mods that alter the sound files usually, or mods that alter graphics, which they only need texture type of files or sound type of files, you won't need to enable and click those on your plugins. So let me set this straight. What you see on the right on your plugin section is the amount of actual plugins we have. You can see the DLC, you can see some of the mods I'm using, and Fallout New Vegas, you could only have around 100 mods installed, but with the mod limit fix, we can go all the way up to the 255 total plugins. And if you hover with your mouse, it tells you again how many ESMs you have, how many ESPs you have, and so on. The difference with an ESM and an ESP is mostly that we have heavy plugins and light plugins. For instance, if you want to install one of the greatest mods when it comes to the Nexus, that is called Titans of the New West, this is a mod that is going to add dozens of new armors. It is going to completely change how power armors work. It will change so many things. And if you're going to install this, for instance, and I have it installed, it will take a spot on your lot order. That's what an ESM does. It takes a spot. We want to use ESMs that are very heavy and they are doing lots of work. We want to avoid using that many ESMs so we can actually have enough space to mod our game. Something I want to show you again is, you see that I have 716 mods enabled? You might say, oh Kavou, that's so many mods. What about keeping a minimalistic view? What about this and that? From the 716 mods, only 254 of those are ESMs, are heavy plugins. Most of them are like the Crash Logger or the Viva New Vegas preset or unofficial patch, or a bunch of millions of patches I'm using. in reality, what I'm doing here, I am using 254 heavy plugins and the rest is patches and things to fix consistency. So do not be intimidated by the number you see, the 716 mods I have. We actually run a totally normal Fallout New Vegas and you can see me play in the background and all of that. When it comes to load order, as you can see, we have the mods installed on the left and the mods installed on the right, or the plugins, should I say. So what's the difference? In a way, in Mod Organizer 2.5, we have two load orders. And this is why I'm going to document those, and I'm going to put on every episode a full list of those, so you won't have to figure this out yourself. I will have everything, my working mod list, my working game, documented, so you can see both of those and adjust them. Many of the mods that do not take an ESM spot, like the fixed ESMs, the Jeep, Johnny Guitar, all of those core mods, they do not take an ESM spot. So we have to put them in an order on the left side of Mod Organizer, where it doesn't break the game, because one successfully override the others. And then on the right, we have to use the plugins and put them in such a way where one overrides the other. When it comes to the left panel over here with the mods, it's very important how you install them. For instance, if you are going to put a bunch of texture type of mods, and here you can see I have a bunch of stuff. I have architecture, landscape, the rock textures, robots HD. What you see here, all of those files are all graphic mods. Graphic mods, they do not take an ESM spot, so we don't have to worry about our plugins. You can install as many of those as you want. But have in mind, when you install those mods, what you put in the bottom, it is going to override the rest. And you can see this by the green icon. If you find this too much, don't worry, because the way I am going to mod and install all of those, it's going to be perfectly fine for your game. So closing in, I don't know what else I have to say other than, if you want to learn how to mod Fallout New Vegas, and if you want Fallout New Vegas to run perfectly, and I mean perfectly, I could play for 23 hours straight without any crashes, without any breaks, because I know exactly what I'm doing and I know exactly the mods to avoid and how to do the right things. So by the end of the series, you are going to have the best looking Fallout New Vegas mod list, without crashes, without issues, with a beautiful running, visually enhanced game. And before closing the video, guys, many of you will ask me, oh Kavou, this is not remastered, this is just vanilla but slightly better. What about Fallout New Vegas Reloaded? But the problem with New Vegas Reloaded is that you are trading those amazing looks, those great aesthetics, if I may, for you getting constant crashes. My idea for Fallout New Vegas and Skyrim and any game is that I want to sit there for an hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, how many hours you want. I want to play the game without having a single crash, without having FPS issues, without having any issue at all. I want things to be as simple and as good as possible. Simple is good, and this is what we are doing here. On the next episode, or should I say episode 1, I guess, of modding, I'm gonna start with Viva New Vegas. It's going to include around 100 and something number of mods that we're going to set together, and I will be updating on the video description the load order on both left and the right panel of Mod Organizer for you to know. We are modding Fallout New Vegas, guys, so welcome to the new series. I only have 7 days to make those videos, because I will be missing on July and August due to work. If I am not going to finish the series, which is very likely that will happen, when I will come back at the start of September, we are going to finish this together. And again, I cover both Skyrim and Fallout when it comes to those type of videos, so give it a thumbs up. Thank you for watching. If you made it through the end of the video, you are a trooper. And again, I will see you guys on the next one. Set of trap, land, peace.